This evening, we're gathered here together to celebrate with you both 10 years of marriage. You'll be 12 years. You'll be renewing your commitment to each other that you made 12 years ago. We're all honored to be part with you this evening, family, friends, loved ones, to be able to share with you this special night that you have both. 1 Corinthians. Paul speaks about the characteristics of love, and he speaks about what love really is. And he goes ahead and he speaks about love, where he says love, first of all, is patient. He goes on to also say love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. He goes on to say it is not dishonor. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. In other words, love always forgives. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, it always trusts, it always perseveres. And I love it how he ends and he says, true love never fails. You see, true love never comes to an end. It is never replaced by anything else. And love is never looking to take, but true love always gives. So now I'm gonna go ahead and ask Kara, go ahead and say your vows.
Danny. Almost 13 years ago, we were two strangers who met for the first time in a youth group parking lot. As I welcomed you to come join us inside, you smiled at me and you told me I was really beautiful. Remember that?
Right.
All these years later, I look back on that memory and I smile. I loved you because of your love for the Lord and your compassion towards others. You would leave change in soda machines for others who didn't have enough money to get me soda. You drove around a group of girls who had no driver's license, back and forth to church and events. You'd read your Bible behind the counter at the coffee shop when no customers were there. I felt so drawn to you. A few months later, we got engaged, and a year later, we married. We didn't truly know what challenges we were about to face as newlyweds. All we knew was that we really loved each other. Today, as we celebrate 12 years of marriage, I feel as though we've accomplished much, and that in itself is worth celebrating. We've faced challenges, sickness, financial struggles, spiritual battles, struggled with communication, and we're still in the process of learning how to love each other selflessly. But I vow to you today to continue to fight the good fight, not to walk away in hardship, and to seek God's will in my own life to become more like Christ and less like me. I desire to be transformed into the wife, the mother, and the woman of God that He's called me to be and to be a blessing to you. I vow to forgive you, to love you, and to stand by your side through every obstacle. I vow to submit myself to you as the spiritual head of our home and encourage you as our leader. I pray that the love of God transforms us together so we rise up year after year and become a powerhouse for the glory of God, just as we wanted to 12 years ago. That's why we chose each other then, and that's why I choose you now. You're my best friend in the world, and I love you.
To my dearest Kara, 12 years ago today, we first committed ourselves to this journey, and you are more precious to me now than ever before. Through our highs and lows, you have been there beside me each step of the way. It hasn't been always been an easy road, but one we've traveled together and helps me reaffirm the love I feel for you every day. I'm not always the greatest at showing it, but my heart's desire is to spend the rest of my days proving my love for you I feel inside. And today before the Lord and these witnesses, I renew and pledge my love and life committed to serving you and our family. I promise to be there for you in good times and bad, through to sickness and in health. I promise to love you whether we're rich or poor, whether we're thin or fat, and whatever this crazy life may bring our way. Till death, my love will last for you. And I look forward to what God holds in store for us, and may we continue to press into His love as He teaches us His unconditional nature in which we should love each other. This I vow to you today. I love you.
So Daniel and Kara, on your wedding day, you exchanged rings as a symbol.
Give me buddy's rings.
Thank you. May you always wear these rings as a reminder of your wedding vows today that you're making to each other. May you continue to live in love, in unity, and in happiness.
There's stuff on there. Get it on there.
There we go.
Got it.
Come on. You get it. You can get the rest of it.
There you go.
I'm going to ask everyone to just extend their hands as we bless their marriage moving forward. Heavenly Father, we come before you, Lord God, and we just come to you, Lord God, in joy and gladness this evening, Lord God, as we see two individuals, Lord God, continue to grow in unity and love. Father, as your word says, Lord God, that love is patient, love is kind, love always perseveres, love keeps no records of wrongs. And Lord God, and may their marriage, Lord God, may their unity be an example of, Lord God, how love never fails. We ask you that you may continue to bless them, help them, give them wisdom, give them guidance in everything that they do. Lord God, that you may raise them up, Lord God, to be the people of God that you've called them to be. We ask you that you bless their home, that you bless everything that their hand touches, Lord God, that it may prosper. We ask you, my God, for their families here tonight, that they are being, Lord God, an evidence to them, Lord God, of what true love really means. We thank you for their lives. We thank you for their example. And we thank you, Lord God, for uniting them here once again.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. So Daniel and Kara also expressed to me how blessed they've been over the 12 years of marriage. And their desire this evening is that all married couples here today, each of you, special friends, relatives, be included in this ceremony of celebrating love. And at this time, they want to offer a special blessing upon all married couples here this evening with them here today. So they want to go ahead and want to pray for all the married couples here this evening as well for you tonight. So we're going to go ahead and want to pray for them.
Father, I thank you so much for everybody who gathered here tonight. I thank you for those who flew a great distance to be here. I thank you for those who live near us. Father, I thank you for this night. And God, I just pray that you would just shower your love down upon everybody here, that they would all know you closely as the Father that you want to be in their lives, Lord, that you would just pour blessings upon them, God, that you would pour favor upon their lives, Lord God. I thank you for your forgiveness, your love, and your mercy towards each and every one of us. God, that your mercies are new every morning. And I bless them in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
So Danny and Kara, as you renew your vows today, you're also renewing your commitment to be loving and caring parents to Jaden, Micah, and Chase, and recognizing with gratefulness and happiness the fulfillment that they have brought to the marriage and the family life, all three of them. So Daniel and Kara, today you have renewed the promises and vows you made to each other. And on your wedding day, you have symbolized the renewal of marriage union by joining hands and taking the vows and by exchanging of rings. It was a pleasure that I conclude the ceremony of renewing vows of marriage that I joined you forever, binds you as husband and wife, and please celebrate these renewal vows with a sign of affection, and you may kiss the bride once again.
Yeah.
Just don't